that'll come back. Delivery day. So, I'm going to do a wee unboxing and we're going to have a wee look at this new titanium stove. This is the Pomeroy Traveller. Just got the hover down now. So, what we're going to do is we're going to have a wee look at this and I'll tell you my initial impressions and stuff. It's actually really light. And what I'll do is I'll come back in a minute. Well, I'll take this out of the bag and I'll show you some, tell you some of the specs. Hey guys, so that's out of the box. So it comes in this really nice bag. The first thing I'll say is this only weighs 1.5 kilos. I thought it was quite a big stove. It's actually really light. It doesn't fold down like some of Pomeroy's other stoves, but I personally like this one. The way it's folded, you'll see when I take it out of the bag. It gives it a lot of strength. So start with the bag. It's a really good thick material bag. It's got some straps on it for strapping it to your bag and stuff. It's actually really quite thick. See, that's about 3 or 4 mil thick. It's got this sort of crisscross pattern on it, so kind of like a ripstop nylon. But it's more sort of canvassy. Decent bag. It looks like it'll be quite robust. It looks like it'll be quite tough. So to the stove. So the stove itself is made of titanium. It's 0.6 mil. With fireproof rivets, no aluminium rivets, and I've seen some of these other stoves that are on the market and people saying they're coming apart and stuff. Basically that's because they've got aluminium rivets in them. The rivets didn't withstand the heat, they start to heat up and they start to melt. So the stove body, so nice looking stove for the onset. Really like the shape of this stove. I love that all the rivets and stuff are actually exposed. It kind of gives it a sort of steampunk, sort of industrial look. So yep, really nice. So the stove, on the bottom of the stove we've got 4 titanium folding out legs. They come out nice and easy. That's the body of the stove. So on the one side of the stove is a flat panel. You've got your glass on the front of the door here, and then you've got your adjuster there for the draw. On the other side, full glass. Now that's brilliant for lighting up your tent and obviously what we call bushcraft tele if you like to watch the fire like most people do. Yeah, great viewing window there. So I'll get the stove open, get the stuff out and let you have a look at what comes. Hey guys, so I've opened up the stove. Stove body's here. So we've got 3 wee bolts on here, hand threaded. Basically, you've got your damper. That's titanium as well. That actually just screws straight onto the body of the stove there. Using your 3 wee nuts, you just undo these 3 wee nuts. What I'll do is I'll bring this close up, let you have a wee look. So this is actually inside the stove. Oh, man, what if I got set on? 3 little bolts here. 1, 2, 3. Place your damper on top of the stove. Put your 3 wee bolts back in. The flue pipe will go obviously directly onto the damper. So once they're on, that gives you total control. So there you go. Also inside this, you have the flue pipe. So the flue pipe is a sheet of titanium, basically completely flat, long sheet of titanium. You have to burn this in to give it some memory. Now I'm going to do this in a separate video rolling this out because there's a technique to it. I've seen several of these and are being bashed and dented and stuff. I have a wee bit of OCD, so mine will need to be nice and straight, so I'll be doing my best for that one. So I'll show you that soon. You've got your retaining rings on there as well, if you can see them, the retaining rings. So that's for once you actually roll this big sheet out and then you roll it round to actually form a stovepipe. So that'll be a separate video, so I'll bring you back for that. Also with this stove, doing the pipe, you get a nice set of anti-cut gloves. That's for rolling the stovepipe out. I suppose you could use them for when you're putting it away and stuff as well. So they're handy to keep a hold of. And they'll stop you cutting your fingers on the titanium, because titanium's got quite sharp edges. Although it is filed, it's good because it's a thin material. You could cut yourself, so really handy to have that. To have the gloves for that. So also inside here, you have the spark arrestor. Now the spark arrestor is really nice. Decent wee design that's on it as well. I don't know if it's got these up, because I put 2 seconds. Right, so spark arrestor. So that's your spark arrestor. That basically goes on the top of your stovepipe, and any sparks that come up from the fire, this kind of helps to stop them from hitting your tent. Now also in here, you have these 3 little tabs. So, hope you can see them all right. So these, I've seen a couple of videos where folk put them in the big bit here and they bend this bit back. I'm not going to do that. What I've noticed is if you stretch them a wee bit and put them into the smaller hole, not only will they not fall in, they won't fall out, they'll stay in place, and that allows you to guy line your stove for if it's a wee bit windy, sorry, your stove pipe for if it's a wee bit windy. So we'll just pop the 3 of these in. There we go, that's the 3 of them popped in. They won't come in and they won't come out. You can see that, that'll let you guy line it out, so handy if the wind gets higher. And that'll stop your stove pipe getting blown around. So, the actual stove, I don't know how well you're going to be able to see this. So, on it inside the stove here in the bottom half, I don't know if you can see this in here, hopefully you can. You've got this internal baffle. Basically, you'll burn your wood on top of that and your ash and stuff will fall through. So what this will do, this will keep a lot of the heat off the bottom of the stove and it'll stop it warping and stuff. So that's a really, really good feature as well. So that should actually help the stove last that bit longer. So on the front of the stove, you've got your wee locking mechanism there for your door, which I probably will modify this and put some sort of wee handle or maybe a key loop or something on that. See what happens. And then you've got, of course, your adjuster to adjust the draw for the stove. So first impressions, it looks really well made. Like really well made. It looks a wee bit like a bouncing bomb, to be honest, but it's really, really light as well. Like I said, it's only 1.5 pounds. So dimension wise, it's 14.6 inches long, it's 7 inches wide, and the body is 18 inches high. So this is slightly smaller than my other stove, so it'll actually probably sit better in the tent. They give you a bit more space, is what I mean. You've also, on the bottom of this as well, got 4 pegging out points. So on the bottom of the leg here, you've got a hole on the bottom of each one, so you can actually peg this in, which also helps when it's windy. When we were out last video there, it was quite windy and the stove was actually rocking. I had to I pegged it down, but I hadn't done that at first. I just pegged over the legs, but with this one, we're having the 4 holes. I think that's really, really, that's a great idea. So what I'll do, guys, is when I roll the stove pipe out, which will be my next video, and we'll burn this in. But what I'm really looking forward to with the titanium stoves is the coloration. These will start to change color. They go purple, blue, red, orange. Every stove looks totally unique once you've burned it in. So I'm really looking forward to that, to see what actual colours it comes out with. I've seen a couple now, and everybody's is sort of different colour. So that's one thing I'm looking forward to, that wee bit. The wee bit where you burn it in and it looks completely different to everybody else's. Well, so the same stove, different colours, everything changes. But you'll see that once I burn it in, guys. So first impressions of the stove, yep, looks like a good bit of kit. So what I'll do is I'll put the link for this in it. This is the Pomeloy Traveller. Pomeloy have got some amazing stuff. You probably noticed in my videos, I've got quite a few Pomeloy things now. Pomeloy sent me this one over, so thanks to the guys at Pomeloy for this one. Really impressed with it, looks really well made. So I suppose the burn will tell, how good it is once you start burning it. So next camp, I'll probably, the winter started to come in here, to be honest. It's been raining and they're saying we might get snow. Snow camp, can't wait. So hopefully it's snowing in the next couple of weeks, but I've got a busy weekend this weekend, so hopefully I'll get out next weekend, possibly before if I get a chance. I'll be taking this with me and I'll see how it performs. So cheers for watching, guys. I'll catch you on the next one.